In this video, patients, families, and donors will learn about the process of directed white blood cell donation and transfusion and how to prepare for it. Our goal is to explain the patient's experience in white blood cell collection and transfusion and the necessary steps of the process. Additionally, this video series will explain the donor's role and options for finding donors. When a patient has cancer and receives cancer treatment, it may affect their immune system, especially their body's ability to produce white blood cells. White blood cells fight infection. When an individual's blood cell count becomes extremely low, the treating doctor may order a special type of transfusion called a white blood cell transfusion, also known as a granulocyte transfusion. Granulocyte is a type of white blood cell. The patients who need this transfusion have an infection that is difficult to treat with antibiotic medications. This type of transfusion is not common and primarily used only by comprehensive specialty cancer treatment centers. White blood cell collection or donation involves several steps. Donors must be at least 17 years old and willing to be screened, tested, and able to take special medications every time they donate. That's why the search for donors begins with family members and friends who are very motivated to help the patient. Also, it's important to know that donors are matched to the patient with ABO compatibility with regard to blood type or antigens in order to donate white blood cells. The white blood cell units are never collected in advance and only held in inventory for up to 24 hours because the units cannot be preserved in a way that would sustain the infection-fighting ability. For the patient, receiving a white blood cell transfusion is very similar to a regular blood transfusion. Pre-medications are usually given to help prevent certain reactions to the transfusion. Fever is a common and expected side effect and is not considered a harmful reaction. Fevers are monitored closely by the treating physicians during and after the transfusion. A decision to postpone or cancel the white blood cell transfusion may be made at any time by the patient's treatment team if the patient has a major change in their condition, such as an unexplained fever, respiratory illnesses, or emergency procedures or surgeries. Patients and donors should be aware that if this happens, the patient will not be able to receive the transfusion from their donor, even though all the steps in the process have been completed. If the transfusion is canceled, the donor is still strongly encouraged to proceed with their donation if he or she has already taken the pre-medications. This is due to the increase in white blood cell count that these medications produce. Keep in mind, white blood cells must be transfused shortly after they are donated for maximum benefit to the patient. Although the transfusion will not go to the intended recipient, it can benefit another patient who does not have a donor. This part of the process can be frustrating for patients and donors. Each treatment team works closely with the transfusion team daily to coordinate care and transfusion orders. Sometimes the decision to give or not give the transfusion must be made just before the scheduled transfusion. The treatment team will always work in the best interest of patients and those donating on their behalf. White blood cell donation requires a strong commitment to the patient and the donation process. A donor must be willing to give of their time for screening and testing and take pre-medications for the procedure. It can also mean traveling to and from MD Anderson three or more times to donate, and the donor may need to take off from work in order to donate. The Blood Donor Operations Department has a team of dedicated personnel who are able to assist the patient and their family in the process of finding and arranging screening for potential donors. If your team of doctors suggests that white blood cell transfusion may be needed in your course of treatment, start looking for donors as soon as possible. There are many available options for patients and family to find donors. The donor operations marketing team can help with ideas to get a patient's message to family and community members to explain why they need this special blood donation. For example, the marketing team can provide sample letters, announcements, and posts to share on social media, websites, and in newsletters. They can also help coordinate a pre-screening blood drive for families who live in our service area. Ask friends and family to help spread the word. Think about contacting groups at work, places of worship, alumni associations, or social organizations. Once potential donors are identified, the donor screening process begins right away. privacy and confidentiality are maintained at all times. MD Anderson will not share patient information with donors and will not share donor information with patients. To learn about the steps involved in the donor process, please watch part 2 of this video series.